By the way, we're going to talk to an energy investor in just a few moments who is still, maybe not surprisingly, bullish on the sector. So we're going to get his case for why people should still be invested in energy stocks as we've got the opening bell here on this Monday morning, coming off a strong week for the major averages as we get further into September, sort of back to school time, a time that does not tend to be good for markets. And speaking of oil, we've got Permian Resources that's ringing the bell here.
We're surrounded.
They knew that we were talking about Occidental, and so that's why they timed it that way.
Absolutely. Taking a look at the major averages, we start off the day positive across the board. That's some of the activity that we had seen coming into the start of this trading session. We've got the Dow, the NASDAQ, and the S&P 500 all in positive territory right now. Also, taking a quick look at some of the sector activity as we've gotten past the opening cross, we're higher across all 11 S&P 500 sectors to begin the day right now.
Yeah, and I want to focus in back to our leaders list here. In the pharmaceutical industry, we're tracking shares of Bristol-Myers Squibb. I'm seeing those up about 7.5%, and this follows the FDA's approval of a new psoriasis treatment for them. And looking at the Wi-Fi Interactive, in the upper right here, we can see up about 7.5%. Also seeing some other love for some of these names in the pharmaceutical sector. Here is a year-to-date chart, and you can see most of the year from about mid-March through just before September here was pretty range-bound. We did have a fake breakout to the upside, but then we dipped here probably, I don't want to speculate as to the cause there, but nevertheless, back up in the territory that we saw for most of the year, probably not going to do much until we get to the 78 level or back down to the 72. But for now, I think investors will take this little bit of good news here for this pharmaceutical company.
I'm looking at Amgen there because that's the one dark red box there on the screen, if we can bring that back up. And I'm just quickly looking at some analyst commentary. Apparently, there is some concern among analysts that that psoriasis drug from Bristol-Myers Squibb will be a formidable competitor to Amgen's offering on the market, which is called Otezla. I believe.
Tesla, yeah.
Tesla.
Yeah, it's in commercials.
And so there you go. That's a good way to know how things are pronounced. And so that perhaps is why it's not great news for Amgen and why we see that underperforming this morning. There's another company, by the way, that's trading off of this called Ventyx Biosciences. And it also has an experimental medication to treat psoriasis. The fact that the FDA approval of Bristol-Myers Squibb did not include a so-called black box warning. Mm-hmm. The read-through is that this is positive for Ventyx's developmental offering in this space. So it's a win for this particular class of treatments, apparently.
Yeah, we got a lot of big movement in biopharma and biotech early this morning and to kick off the week. I mean, Merck or Spergen, they also made an acquisition that was announced today as well. That acquisition of a company called PharmaLex, and so that going to be moved forward as well. But just getting back to briefly the significance of this particular approval that they're getting from the FDA for Bristol-Myers here, because you think about the total population, it's about 2-3% of the world's total population that has some form of psoriasis. So a potential treatment and one that would allow for a Bristol-Myers Squibb to enter directly into competition with the other offerings out there. I think that's exactly what's being really latched onto about the significance of how this could really treat the 125 million people globally that are impacted by psoriasis as well.
I'm one of those people, believe it or not, yes.
Nice.
Although I don't take heavy-duty medication, but still, yes, it's good that...
Significant improvement.
It's good to have choices.
Definitely, definitely indeed.